respects, describes all of us, one to which we can probably all relate. Jesus arrived unexpectedly at the home of dear friends, and within minutes, Mary found herself sitting at Jesus' feet. She was listening intently to what Jesus was saying, just sort of soaking up every word. And then there's Martha. Martha is the older sister, and as such, she was used to being the one in charge, the one who took control. I can't help but wonder how many of us have an older brother or an older sister like that that love to take charge, to be in control, especially when mom and dad weren't home. Martha was the one that scurried around, picking up, straightening up, being sure the house was presentable. And then there was a menu to plan, cooking to do, a table to set. And to make matters worse, Jesus brought his 12 friends with him. Now come on, ladies that are here today and those that are in our viewing audience, how would you feel if you were sitting at home, relaxing, maybe having just a peaceful afternoon, and all of a sudden, a friend, Jesus, and 12 of his friends show up on your doorstep. 13 extra people showing up at your home that you were not anticipating. She was worried about how she's going to get everything done. Oh, if only I had known they were coming, I could have planned. I could have been more prepared. Something we need to realize when we read this text is opening up the door and welcoming in a stranger. Welcoming travelers wasn't just a nice thing to do. Hospitality was a social requirement in their culture. It was considered to be shameful to turn anyone away from your door. Martha's family obviously took that commitment, that responsibility, that requirement very seriously. Martha worried about the details. She wished to please, to serve, to do the right thing. But she often succeeded in leaving everyone around her feeling uncomfortable. My mother used to be that way. She used to hover around the table, making sure that everything was just right. Everybody had enough beverage to drink, and everybody had enough food, and there was everything on the table that needed to be there. She, like Martha, I believe, was a worrier. Sometimes, in fact, with my mother, we would say, "Mom, you're worrying about things that you don't even need to be worrying about." I swear sometimes she'd worry because she didn't have something to worry about. I think that's maybe a little of the way Martha was. But my mother, just like Martha, wanted everything to be just perfect. And I have a feeling that's how most women are today. Perhaps as the oldest, she feared shame if her home did not measure up to the expectations of the day. She tried to do everything she could to make sure that wouldn't happen. And as a result, she found it hard to relax, to enjoy her guests, and even harder to accept Mary's lack of cooperation in all the preparations. I love the different reactions of Mary and Martha. Mary, she just sat down at Jesus' feet. She listened to what he said. Looking up at him, again, that picture I think shows it so well. Looking up at him, soaking in every word, sitting at the feet of the teacher, thirsting for his words. So, does Scripture give us any other examples of people sitting or kneeling or bowing at the feet of Jesus? I think one of them came in that we can look at, which is a quick reference, Luke 8:41-42. It's the story of Jairus. You may remember that story. become stagnant, indifferent, complacent in our faith. And in time, we will fall away from God's teachings. Unlike Mary, we find Martha just overwhelmed and stressed and frustrated with the preparations. I love that picture. It represents so well what she was feeling that day. And the text said, Martha was distracted by all the preparations she had to be made. And she came to the Lord and she said, "Don't you care that my sister has left me to do all of the work by myself? Tell her to help me." Yeah, all right. I don't think that's how she would have gone to Jesus, do you? I think she would have gone to Jesus and said, "Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do all the work by myself? Tell her to help me." I think that's what a frustrated Martha would have done. Much like what you and I would do when we have a sibling that isn't helping out. Oops. Happened to my son. There it is. And Martha answered, Jesus answered, "Martha, Martha, you're worried and upset about many things, but few things are needed, or indeed only one. Mary has chosen what is better, and it will not be taken from her." Oh my. I'm not sure we can be too hard on Martha. After all, there was work to be done. Jesus and his disciples had to be fed. It was a social obligation, part of being a good host. We do know that Mary sat at Jesus' feet and worshiped. And Martha, she scurried around and got angry. And the longer she was doing the work, the angrier she got. Picture what's going on for a minute. Picture that whole scenario, because I think it represents two images of what we see happening sometimes, not only in our own homes, but unfortunately we see it happening in our churches from time to time. You see, that's what work without worship did to Martha. And if we aren't careful, that's what work without worship will do to us. It caused Martha to get upset. It caused her to talk instead of to listen. It caused her to be critical of her sister. It caused her to doubt the love of Jesus Christ. It caused Martha to be discouraged, frustrated. What did Martha do? She ran to Jesus and she ran on her sister. You ever have a sister that went and ratted on you because you weren't doing something? Or a brother? I have. I came across an interesting quote. It says, "Beware of the barrenness of busyness." Beware of the barrenness of busyness. In other words, beware of the emptiness, the lack of substance, the lack of purpose that comes from being overly committed to being busy. Don't we sometimes get so caught up in busy work that we lose sight of our real meaning and purpose? I do. concerned about the household chores, he was only asking her to set priorities. You see, it's possible for service to Christ to degenerate in the mere busy work that's no longer full of devotion to God. It can happen if we aren't careful. When you look at that text, Martha, Martha, the Lord answered, you're worried and upset about many things. What do you see? What do you hear in Jesus' words? I hear love. I hear compassion. I hear tenderness. Martha, Martha, you're worried and you're upset. You see, Jesus looked within Martha and saw a troubled heart. When you and I are walking through the reality of dark and difficult times, you ever find yourself wondering if anybody really cares? God knows. And I truly believe that God cares. Amen? Amen. God knows what's going on in your heart. He knows what's going on in your life. In 1 Peter 5, verses 6 and 7, Peter says, humble yourselves, therefore, under God's mighty hand, that he may lift you up in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you. We need to take that verse personally within ourselves. I can cast all my anxiety on Jesus because he cares for me. Make it personal. I encourage you to do that with many of the scriptures. Make it personal. You know, there's absolutely no doubt that both Mary and Martha loved Jesus. And in their own ways, they were both serving him. Mary by listening to Jesus, Martha by making preparations for him. But Martha thought that Mary's way of serving Jesus was inferior to her own. That's where we get in trouble sometimes. But what she didn't realize was that in her desire to serve, she was actually neglecting some of her guests. Martha made one important, very important omission. She forgot to take time to worship. She got so caught up in the busyness, she forgot to worship. And unfortunately, just like Martha, we can easily get so caught up doing things for Jesus that we forget to spend time with Jesus. come to me all